Yeah, thank you. Great to be here. Especially congratulations also to BRE for 25 years. Redevco is a European real estate investment manager focusing on retail real estate. We have about 6.5 billion euros of assets under management, 400 retail buildings, high street shops, retail parks, and shopping centers spread throughout Western Europe. And we are a long-term investor, and we have decided already back in 2007 to use the BREEAM methodology to start measuring the environmental impact of our portfolio. It's been a long journey, 9 years so far, but in the meantime, we have about 88% of our assets under management certified with a BREEAM certificate. And from here, we now say we know where we are, and we can start making conscious choices in our asset management to make improvements in our portfolio and to take our buildings to the next level. In that sense, to make them future-proof and to make sure that we're trying to contribute to a reduction in overall energy consumption and CO2 emissions.
Great, thank you, Thijs.
As Richard already stated, investment manager with PGGM for 8 years. PGGM manages and administers the Dutch pension funds. Assets under management, roughly 200 billion. Real estate, 11%, so quite significant. 50-50 split between listed and private. On the private side, we initiated in a year later than Clemens actually in 2008. We adopted our belief that sustainability definitely pays off. And we also wrote our real estate responsible investment policy for real estate investments. That actually started our engagement with the policy measuring, and now we're trying to get improvements. And I think it's fair to say that we are very proud that from the latest GRESB results, 70% of our portfolio is a Green Star, has received a Green Star rating, and 20% of the total portfolio is in the upper quintile. And that provides for us the confidence and the evidence that sustainability definitely pays off. How much it financially pays off, that's a question, but we strongly also believe it's a risk diversifier. It reduces the risks of the asset, and we achieve it by engaging with our partners. We invest only indirect in real estate, either listed or private. And I'm very happy to understand that parties like Redevco are very committed and very engaged in improving sustainability, because from a Dutch pension perspective, that is really necessary, because our pensions for the beneficiaries are being paid out in 2025 and even longer periods. So it needs to be sustainable. So as a closing remark for the intro, PGGM has a solution in investments, like we say, and that commits to the UN Sustainable Development Goals, in which they picked four themes: climate and environmental, food, health, and water, and we try to make there the difference, have a clear focus on it.
Great, thank you. Martin, what about your 25th birthday?
Yeah, what a good question, and what an introduction from everybody else as well. So Martin Townsend, Director of Sustainability at BRE. So my role, to answer Richard's question, is about trying to maintain and drive that standard. So we've heard already from some of the users and some of the interested parties. What we do as a research charity is making sure that that standard is the best it can be, based on international best practice. We operate in 70 countries worldwide. And I think every country, there's something to learn from in terms of what is best practice and how can we help investors and owners and tenants make sure the building's the best they can be. That 25-year journey, I was reflecting on the plane this morning, has been a hell of a journey, and I think it will come out in a debate, I'm sure, that we are now in a really exciting times when we talk about sustainability, because I think the rate of change is much, much quicker now than we've seen in earlier years. And it's about making sure we understand the true life cycle of the building in terms of moving from new construction to operation and refurbishment, but also looking at the social and economic issues as well as the business case, as been mentioned already. So my role is to make sure we drive that. And we have great conversations like this, because I know today we're going to have a series of great conversations to make sure that we keep on moving the industry forward, because it is about progress.
Okay, good. Simone.
Yeah, my name is Simone Lakenbrink. I am founder of The Diffney, I think the unknown company in this group. We are, since 2012, the licensee of BRE for the German-speaking nations, Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. The idea was, even if we are Germans and used to the English language, I don't know if we don't want to, but we don't do it. So the uptake was with Bream in a German language with German standards. And we made it very successfully for Bremen use in the three countries. And I'm very happy to announce today that we joined TÜV Süd, so that the small Diffney is now a member of the TÜV Süd group. And we hope that this will be a more push on the market, and we will start now with implementing sustainability in these countries.
Good, thank you. Martin.
Yeah, Richard, thank you. My name is Martin Meulen. I'm the Regional Managing Director for RSCS in Europe, Russia, and CIS. And RSCS, for the people who don't know the organization, is a non-profit organization operating worldwide and trying to basically make the land, property, and construction sector more ethical and more professional. And from that perspective, I hope that I can give a different angle to the debate today, because it's all about buildings. But for me, when we talk about sustainability, it's about more than just buildings and making them more green, so to speak. I think we should also pay attention to the governance component or the social component of buildings. And I think if we talk about sustainability, we have to have a broader discussion also today and also for the next 25 years, so to speak. Talking about buildings, of course, we know about that as well. And in particular, when it comes to valuation of buildings and the impact of sustainability measurements on the value of assets, that's very important, first of all. But also, when we start refurbishing buildings, it's now more and more a topic that we are going to investigate, because that has an impact on the valuation too.